Hello and welcome to our unit on meter and beats in music. When you're looking at a piece of music, it's very important to be able to feel where the beat is. And a lot of students do struggle with this. In my experience, some students, especially if they have a background in band or choir, it's a little bit easier for them. But some students be able to hear the beats and to be able to count them and know how to organize them into meters can prove quite challenging. But as with anything in life, if you practice it and you stay with it and you keep with it, you will get better. So I have a few examples here I've prepared, and we're going to walk you through some of these meters. The first one we're going to start with is duple meter. Duple means two. So I have a virtual drum set over here, and just bear with me because I'm having to play it on the keyboard. So sometimes I may like clap and hopefully the mic will pick it up okay. Other times I may use this virtual set and do things like this to illustrate different meters and stuff. Again, I can't promise I'll play it perfectly because I'm playing using the typing keyboard to access the different drums. All right, so let's talk about duple. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to be mainly relying on this bass drum here to symbolize beat one, because beat one is always the most important beat in any meter. And meter is just how we arrange the beats, because not all beats are equal. It's not a democracy. Beat one is always the most important beat. And so that's the one that we definitely want to hear for, so we can identify it. All right, so you have beat one. To make it duple, you need a weak beat. Your beat one is going to be your strong beat. Beat two is going to be your weak beat. So it's going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and so forth. So I have an example here of duple meter. And in jazz especially, if you're listening to a piece of jazz or rock and roll or modern day country music, a lot of times the bass or the drums or the guitar or some element of the rhythm section is going to be giving you a good hint of where the beat is, because most modern day music has a, you know, some instrument hitting the beat, or at least hitting most of the beats. So in rock and roll, for instance, you know, it's common to hear a beat, you know, that yeah, let me find my snare drum. There we go. So if you have something like this, then you can tell that there's the drums are hitting most of the beats. 1, 2, 3. Like that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So even though some notes are not playing exactly on the beat, there's still some strong indication of where the beats are. So we're going to play this duple meter example, and we're going to see if you can detect where the beat is. I'll give you a hint on this one, because if you listen to the bass is hitting every beat. So check it out. And hopefully you were able to detect that beat. I'm going to cut the music volume down a little bit, and then I'm going to hit the beat out here for you. So when listening to a piece like this, you're going to hear where that duple beat is. It's going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So that's how duple meter sounds. Now triple meter is going to be just an added weak beat to it. So instead of just a single weak beat like 1, 2, 1, 2, you're now going to have two weak beats after beat one. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, like that. So that's triple meter. And here we have an example of a fairly slow triple meter here. Hear that? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And sometimes students get caught up because they end up listening to the melody or they listen to the rhythm of the accompaniment or something like that, and it throws them off. The main thing that you need to realize is that beats are always consistent. They're not irregular. They're not jagged. They don't go bump, ba-bump, ba-bump, ba-bump like that. You know, they don't have that irregular where some notes are closer to others. Beats are always regular like this. And the way to remember that is that we often call the beats in music the pulse in music, and we measure our heartbeat by our pulse. And as long as you're sitting still and not, you know, running around or doing any strenuous activity, or you're not being scared or something, your heart should be beating at a steady pulse. And therefore, that's an easy way to remember that. So if you're counting, you know, the beats to a piece and they seem a little irregular or off, then you need to rethink how you approach it. Again, listen for the rhythm section, which is the drums, the rhythm guitarist, not the lead guitarist that's playing like the lead, but the rhythm guitarist strumming the chords, the piano, if there is one, and the bass, and instruments like this often in the background, they'll be hitting the beats more regularly. All right, so that's triple meter, and now we're going to move to a quadruple meter. Quadruple meter is three weak beats after the initial strong beat. So instead of like duple where it's strong, weak, strong, weak, or triple where it's strong, weak, weak, strong, weak, weak, there's three weak beats after it. So 1, 2, 3, that's triple. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's quadruple. And you heard that there were three weak beats in there. It can be confusing sometimes distinguishing between duple and quadruple because they're mathematically related. But the main thing to listen for in quadruple is that although beat three definitely gets a little bit more oomph than two and four it doesn't get as strong as one. So if you're hearing a piece of music and it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, you really gonna want to listen for that really strong stress every four beats. Whereas in duple, it's pretty strong. It's 1, 2, 1, 2. Like every other beat is a really strong beat. And so it's pretty easy to hear the difference between the two with a little bit of practice. All right, so here is a very quick quadruple meter example here. They told him, don't you ever come around here. Don't want to see your face, you better disappear. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can hear that that is quadruple. If you go back and you try to, say, fit triple meter into it, it doesn't work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to count it as triple meter, and you're going to see that it doesn't work at all. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And you can see that that just seems off kilter. It seems like, you know, I'm almost tapping out the beat to some other song other than the one you're hearing. It only makes sense if you are counting in line with the music. So, and again, like I said, this will take some practice for some people, and it just will take a few tries at it. All right, so we're going to look at another quadruple meter example here. Let's see if you can hear the four beats. Here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that was a very fast-paced quadruple meter. And tempo is the word that we use to describe the speed in which the beats come at you. So you can have, you know, fast duple, slow duple, fast quadruple, whatever. Now, where students tend to struggle a little bit is with compound meters. Compound meters, basically what you do is you subdivide the beats into strong, and then there's almost like a second layer of meats underneath that that are usually divided into threes. So take like duple meter, for example. Yes, you only have a strong beat and a weak beat, which is 1, 2, 1, 2. Now, in compound time, we subdivide each of those strong and weak beats into three more beats. So what we end up having is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can hear the bass drum and the hi-hat are the strong and weak beats. And then on the tom, I'm hitting the second layer of beats, which is like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. But it's a 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you feel that kind of swaying where it's 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, like that, the main thing to listen for is the second set of the three beats, is it just as strong as the first? So if you've got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, and each of those ones is strong, then that's going to be regular old triple meter. But where it's going to be compound is the beat on the hi-hat here, which is played by that. If you hear the weak beats also getting that extra three beats attached to it, then that's compound time. So it's 1, 2, 3. Let me hit the right one there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can hear there's only one strong one. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2. That one is really going to get a nice surge. Whereas if it's a really fast-paced triple meter, it's going to be 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Like that. So, and I have an example of a pretty fast triple meter that someone may confuse with compound. But first of all, let me play you a song that you are maybe familiar with that is in compound time. So, actually, I have this mislabeled here. This is duple compound. So, this is When a Man Loves a Woman by, oh, the name's escaping me. Percy Sledge, I believe, is the guy's name. But this is a song, When a Man Loves a Woman. This is in standard compound time. It's duple compound, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And notice how strong the one that comes around is. All right, let's back that up a little bit. I'm going to cut the volume down a little bit so you can hear me over the music. So here's where the beats are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And you can hear how strong the beat one is in that. So if you want some practice counting duple compound time, then pull up When a Man Loves a Woman and see if you can't count along to the entire song. Again, it just takes practice and it takes consistency. You can't get frustrated too quickly and give up. So, like I said, I'm going to play a really fast-paced triple meter song here, and you'll see how some people may confuse this for that duple compound time, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But you'll notice that beat one, which comes every three beats, is really strong. So it's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So listen for that really strong beat one. All right, so once again, I'm going to cut the volume down a little bit and I'm going to walk you through the beats here. Listen to how strong beat one is in this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And that's how that's organized. That's how you know it's triple meter instead of duple compound. All right, and you can have other compounds. You can have a triple compound, which would be And I'm just going to use the bass and the hi-hat here for one, two, three, like that. You can have triple compound where you have three main beats, but each is subdivided into three. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's pretty uncommon, though. You don't see that too often in music. Really, duple compound is the one that you see the most in modern-day pop music and stuff like that. And occasionally you do see irregular measures. There are very unusual examples. You're not going to come across them very much. But every once in a while in a blue moon, you'll come across a song, especially by a more creative artist, that want to do weird meters, like 5 beats per measure, where you have to subdivide that into like 2s and 3s. So if you want to do 3 beats followed by 2, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2. And so you really get into some complex rhythms when you do that. And, you know, I've even seen where they do irregular meters and then subdivide it into compound time. And so there's some wacky stuff out there, but most of the stuff that you listen to, most of the stuff that is considered pop music, and even quite a bit of the classical repertoire is going to stick to these standard meters here. And quadruple meter is by far the most common meter in especially pop music. So you will hear quadruple meter a lot. Matter of fact, I would say if you're in doubt whether or not it's duple or quadruple, go with quadruple almost every time. And that's going to bring us to our last discussion point here, and that's phrasing. You see, we arrange music into phrases usually, and we do this using a few elements of the music. The main thing you want to listen for is the melody. The melody is really what's phrased the most. But there are going to be times where, like, say, if you're listening to jazz and you have a drum solo, the drum solo is not going to be melodic at all. It's just going to be pure rhythm. But you're still going to get a sense of it having a starting point, and it's going to have a middle point, and then an end. Just like when you're listening to someone speak, you can naturally hear where the punctuation is without them having to make any weird sounds to let you know. So if someone's talking to you and then they just stop mid-sentence, you can tell like something is not right with that, like it's incomplete. You're waiting for them to finish the sentence. So the same way with music. If you have someone playing a piece of music and they go ba-ba-do-ba, ba-ba-do-ba, ba-ba-do-ba-ba-ba-ba-da, ba-ba-do-ba, ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba-bum. Like that kind of almost sounds like a complete sentence. It sounds like you have a starting point and kind of an end point. Or if they're singing like Mary Had a Little Lamb, they could go ba-da-da-da-da-da-dum-dum-dum. And if they stop there, you sense that that's incomplete, because we organize our musical sounds in most music into phrases. And so there are common groupings of measures into phrases. The most common are 8. Sometimes you will see 10. Sometimes you will see 12. And sometimes 16. It all depends on the piece of music. And some will even have weird numbers like 11 and stuff like that. So the main thing is make sure you're counting your measures. Make sure you listen for the flow of it and kind of hear where it starts and then hear where it ends. So we're going to play an 8-measure example of quadruple meter, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4. And listen for this to form an 8-measure phrase. You'll notice there's 8 measures total in this, and it forms a complete musical sentence. So let me make sure the volume's turned up here. Okay, here it is. ABC, easy as 1, 2, 3. Okay. All right. If you didn't hear it the first time, you can listen for the hi-hat, which is a sound in that. And that's pretty much hitting right on the beat. But you'll notice that this is 8 measures and it forms a musical phrase. So when you're listening to it, I'm going to cut the volume down here so you can hear me. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. And if you go back and actually count all of those in that piece, that selection, it ends up being 8 total measures. So that's a musical phrase. And here's an example of a 12-measure phrase. So this one has a total of 12 measures in quadruple meters. So you would count 1, 2, 3, 4, 12 times. And as I've mentioned in many of my classes, you may want to use the tally method of recording these beats, because sometimes when you're dealing with like 12 and 16 measure phrases, you can get lost real easy. So it really helps sometimes to have a piece of paper. I do this sometimes when it's a complex piece of music. So if you're counting, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4, 4, 2, 3, 4. And then you draw the slash for the 5, 2, 3, 4, 6, 2, 3, 4, 7, 2, 3, 4, 8, 2, 3, 4. And that lets you know it's 8 measures. Do not get in the habit of going 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, because you're just going to, you're going to. That's actually probably going to get you lost quicker than if you just write a slash per measure. So it's very important that you know what meter you're dealing with. If you're hearing it and it's going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, then you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, because that would be triple meter. But this is quadruple, where we'd count 4. So that's how I suggest you keep up with it. And you may want to do it for this one, because this is a 12 measure example here. And once you get over 8, like even sometimes 8 is hard to count without using a tally. But see if you can count all 12 measures in this. Okay, did you get all 12? If not, I'm going to play it one more time, give you an opportunity to get it and make sure that you have all 12 measures. So here we go. So what we're going to do is I'm going to pull paint back up again, and I'm going to count along with you in this final example that we're going to look at. We're going to look at a 16 measure phrase in quadruple meter. So let's pull up the 16 measure phrase here, and I'm going to get my brush here ready to go, and I'm going to be counting along. And you may see me have to kind of catch up, because I'm going to have to click over here and then go over here, but just bear with me. Let's do this here. All right, I had a mouse slip there. Bear with me just one second. I'm going to erase this, and we're going to start over. Okay, just bear with me. I'm gonna back it up here. And this one does go by fairly fast. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3, 4. So I apologize for that, but my hand slipped on the mouse there. All right, so here it is again. Let's try this. This is take two. All right, and you see I end up with a total of 5, 10, 15, 16 measures there. And like I said, I did have to kind of catch up at the beginning there. But that's a good way of writing out your measures. Just don't slip on your mouse and you'll do fine. So again, this is going to take practice. This is going to just take some listening, listen to all kinds of music. Just go on the internet and just have fun, explore. Feel free to Google stuff like, hey, is there any heavy metal in triple meter? And you'd be surprised what you can find. So have fun with it. By all means, see me if you have any other questions or you want to get some one-on-one time, and maybe we can look at a few songs together. We can either do that via Skype or in person. But I do want you guys to get this stuff down, and I think you'll find with a little bit of practice, it's pretty easy.